Hello, hi. I'm here again with another chat with you. Ready for a very deep conversation now. Yes, I have something to talk today that is going to shake you up. but I'm here to shake you up anyway. And let me tell something. When I do chats like this, I'm not just talking to you. I'm talking to myself, okay? I'm just trying to learn as I'm giving it out, because when I'm chatting, when I'm not talking alone. There is spiritual beings with me, giving me the insights. Remember one of my chats was for that our thoughts they're not creating our brain. You receive the information and our brain decoded it. Yes? Okay, if you look at that principle, then we know that I'm not talking just with you, I'm talking to me, because I'm receiving the information. The information is coming to my brain. Yes, I do some research, etc. But 90% that I'm talking comes naturally. So I'm just being decoding and putting in words what the universe is trying to tell me and tell you. Okay? So today, I hope you have been enjoying it. And please don't forget to put like if you like it and leave your comments. Okay? It's very much appreciated. Okay. What I'm talking about today is the only problem in your life is you. Oh, you don't like this, do you? Yeah, but the only problem in your life is you. That's not a good news, is it? Let me tell you something. It's a very good news if you are ready. If you are ready and if you are willing to embrace this knowledge. If you are willing to embrace this knowledge, this is a very good news. Because then it's putting in your hands the power of changing. Let's talk about your brain. What have your brain been doing lately? Full of bullshit? Full of, stupid thoughts? Horrible desires? Huh? Craving things that you shouldn't be craving for? How is your mental state? Are you step on the ground and, looking at situation with positivity and trying to change what is not good? Or are you just listening to your monkey chatting on your brain and telling you all this bad news? Tell me your thoughts, your fantasies. What have you been listening lately? Sitting in front of the television and feeding your brain with untruth, stupid fantasies, yeah, bad news, delusions. 99% of the programs in the TV are delusions, not true. Even news, some news are fabricated, to put down some people that is supporting another, you know, another party. Yeah. So what are you feeding your brain? Can you imagine go inside your brain right now? What you're gonna found in there? Are you be scared? Are you be proud? Are you gonna be proud or are you gonna be scared? You're gonna be disgusting. Go inside your brain right now. How are you gonna feel? What are you finding in there? Pleasure? Good news, bad news? Can you support to be with yourself? Can you enjoy being with yourself? Or are you so tired of you that you wanna just run away from yourself? What have you been filing in your brain? What's the fires in your brain? What have you been storing in your brain? And our brain has a lot of storage in there. Your brain is your age. And your brain has been storing information from when you are inside your mother's womb. So what have you been storing so far in inside your brain? Remember, your only problem in life is you, is what is inside here. What is driving you is what's inside your head. It's what you are feeding your brain with. That is your problem. That is my problem. What have you been, what I have been feeding my brain? Bullshit. So I'm gonna have bullshit. The consequence is gonna be bullshit. Yeah. If I feed my brain with bad news, the only thing I'm gonna attract to myself is bad news, because that's what, whatever you think is what you are. Whatever you are is what you attract. So one is linked to the other. Whatever you think is what you are. Whatever you are feeding your brain is what you are. And whatever you what you are is what you are attracting to you. What files your brain has been using lately? That you are horrible, that you are ugly, that you are stupid, that nothing goes right. What have you been feeding your brain with? You are a failure. Yeah, that's what you are saying to yourself every single day. Or you can't do nothing right because you know you don't have a proper education. Really? That's what you are feeding your brain? This is so easy done. You know, it's what you do every day. How stupid you are. What have you been doing it? Can you see? That is blaming yourself. That is, you are the one that is, I don't need even to tell, to be cruel to you. You are the one that is cruel with yourself. Yeah. No one needs to throw stones on you. You are throwing your stone. You are destroying yourself. What the hell? No one needs to destroy you. You are destroying yourself. No one is destroying you apart from yourself. Because when you think bad, you're going to attract bad. And when you attract bad, you're going to have it. And then you're going to blame everyone else. Oh, it's the environment. It's the politics. This is my situation. It's because everything is trouble in the world. No, it's you that is the trouble. The world is fantastic. The planet is beautiful. And the planet will be very well without us. Do you know that? The nature will be very, very happy without us, because we are destroying everything. Yeah. They will be better off without you and me. So who is destroying who here? Is you destroying yourself, me destroying myself? And destroying the planet. Because what you are is what you do and what you attract. There is more negative fires in your brain than positivity. If there is more negativity on your brain, how in hell you wanna have positive things come into your life? It's no way. It's a law. It's the law of nature. It's the law of nature. You can't change it. You have to embrace this law and say, okay, that is not avoidable. That is what it is. So let me change myself. Let me change my brain, the way I think. You know, men, woman, wake up. What you are inside is what you transmit, you emit outside. What you are in here is what you are giving up. So if you are insecure inside yourself, you are gonna show it on your aura, in your energy field, in your face, in your attitude. I'm gonna give you an exercise. I love to do it now and then. I have to take airplanes or trains very often. And when I am waiting and looking at people around me, you know, I look at everyone and I can tell who is being proactive and who is being negative. I know who is feeling shit and who is not feeling shit. Pay attention. The next time when you are on a shopping center or wherever, sit, take a time, 5-10 minutes, sit down there and pay attention to people walking around. It's amazing. What I'm saying to you is the same way I'm paying attention and observing when a person is feeling loser, by the way they walk, by the way they look at you, by the way they see the posture, the body posture, you can see when the person is, you know, with the control figure, when they know what they are doing and when they don't. You can see a person that is a hero from the one that is not. When the person is a winner and when the person is a loser, you can see by the body, you can see by the energy that are emitting. They are, you know, walking and emitting it. What you're feeding your brain is what your body, your, you know, spiritual body is embracing. Remember the mental body, the astral body, the physical body. The physical body is the one that is emitting this energy to the astral body. So by the aura of the person, by the way they walk, you can perceive it. You can look at it. So how people is going to look at you in the street? A loser? Because that's the energy you are emitting? Or they are going to see in you a winner? All depends on you. No one is doing it to you. It's you doing to yourself. So when you go for a new interview, for a new job, the guy is going to look at your posture. He's there to judge you and see if you are fit for the job. And if you are a loser, who wants to have a loser on the team? Tell me. And how are you going to change it? Here. So if you don't gain a job, a new job, it's because it's fault of the person that is doing, he didn't like me. Why he didn't like you? What have you done for him not to like you? What the energy you are emitting? What the energy you are giving out to that person not to like you? Do you understand me? the change in the planet doesn't depend in the others, depends on you. If you change inside yourself, if you change here, then you are changing the world, because the world is you. A lot of people say, oh, let's change the world, when they don't want to change themselves. You're not going to change the world sitting down in front of a television looking at the silly programs all day long. No! It's a delusion of your brain. You're not going to do it. People that change the world is the one that goes for meditation, the ones that do something about themselves. They are feeding themselves with a good food. So when you feed yourself, when you give yourself a good, you know, if you give to yourself a good environment inside, not just outside. Okay, if you have a way of giving a good environment outside, like, you know, you don't need to have lots of money to have a good environment. I did myself here. I have a lovely house with lots of plants, lots of good little spaces that raises up the energy. Okay, a lot of crystals around my house. You know, you can buy crystals for £4. You can buy the sea salt lamp for £10. So you create an environment in your house that is helping you to make these changes from outside also. So you change inside and you change outside. But you have to do it inside yourself first. Change your mentality. Because the only person responsible for you to fail something or win something is yourself. The only problem in your life is you. It's no one else. It's not your father, it's not your mother. It's not your friends, it's not your brothers, sisters. No, it's you. It's not your teachers. No, it's you. You. You are responsible for your life. You are responsible for what you feel. You are responsible for what you eat. You are responsible for what you are feeding your brain. And the only one that can make the changes is you. No one else. No one, even God. You can pray as much as you want. Oh God, change my life. It's not going to change because you are the one to change. You are the God of yourself. You are the one responsible for your future, for your past, from your past, and for your present. You have to control your life. You are the one that has to control your life. Care, who is controlling? Are you controlling your thoughts or your thoughts controlling you? Is your chat monkey? Your chatting monkey is in controlling? He's the boss? He's the one that is dictating you what you do? Who is telling you what to do? Is you? Or your brain? Are you controlling your chat monkey, or he's the one that is controlling you? That's make the difference. If you can control your thoughts, if you can control your chat monkey inside you, in your head, you're gonna be a loser forever. Are you in your body? Or is your chat monkey in your body? Yes. Is your chat monkey in your body? Huh? Are you attracting energies from the dark side? Are you? Who is in command? Who is in control? Tell me. When you have a bad thought, you know, when you have anger, when you, your pride is too good that you can't even listen to other people. You think that you're right always, and everyone is wrong. You attract this type of energy to you. And I'm gonna tell you something, not just physical people around you, you attract energies also around you. If you are with anger against someone, you're gonna attract energies, diseased energies that died with anger in the heart. And I'm gonna tell you, there is loads of people that died in anger, in fear. They died because of drugs. They died because they were being killed and they don't accept this. So they have a lot of anger inside, a lot of hatred inside themselves. And when you have the same feelings alive, they are, can be attracted to you. And they come and glow to your energy and start to feed by your energy. That is serious. Everyone should know about it. You not just attract people that is alive, but you attract people that is dead. People that they are not feeling and they are not going, they are not moving to the next level. People that don't accept they are dead. There is a lot of information about what happened to you when you die. And some people, when they die, they're not ready for dying. So, because of the state of the brain, brains like ours, brain like yours. And when they die, they don't go to a good place because they got completely lost. They think they're still alive, you know? They keep trying to come home. They keep trying to do things as normal as they used to do. They go to the jobs, you know, and they don't understand why people are not looking at them and seeing at them and answer the questions, etc. So they are in confusion, a state of confusion. And some people stay in this stage for a long time until they accept that they are dead. Until then, they will try to, you know, be around. So all this type of energy, you know, if you are feeling anger, this energy, you, the anger energy that you are emitting is going to attract this type of people. If you feel sad, people that is sad on the other side because they don't found a way, they tend to be attracted to you. If you are using drugs, the one that dies with drugs come and you know, stick you, with you because they are feeding from you. People that die with anger or hungry, you know, they tend to go to people that like to eat too much. Sometimes you are eating, but not you. The other ones is eating the food you are eating. When you, for example, when you eat for just eating, you don't know why, you just finish eating and you want to eat something else. You know what I mean? This a normality of eating, this normally comes from a spirit that is with you because that's what you're attracting to you because of here. And you're going to ask me, how do I avoid it? Working on yourself. Saying, no, I am in command of my brain, I am in command of my life, and I do what I want to do, and no one is going to control my thoughts, no one is going to control my energy, I am in control. You have to be the boss of your destiny, the boss of your life, the boss of your environment. You know, some people say, oh, if you have a bath salt, it's gonna help. Well, it can help for about 5 minutes. And then when this energy that from the bath salt is over, they'll come back again. Oh, you have to incense your house. Yes, you can incense your house. They're gonna be out for half a day and then you come back again. Do you understand? Because it's not what you do. The change of the environment has to be in tune with the change of you inside. If you sing in all day, if you sing all day, if you have music on your brain, but not bullshit music, for God's sake. There is so many raps today that, oh, if you kill someone, this one is gonna attract the killing. Not the positive stuff. Do you understand? Even music, you have to be careful when you sing it. If you are singing that in depression, etc., what are you gonna bring to your life? Do you understand how serious it is what you allow to come from your ears? And then you said, oh, Miriam, then life is gonna be impossible. Oh, the way you are driving our planet? Yes, it's getting impossible. But who has the power to change? Us. If you don't keep in buying this bullshit music that is telling about killing people who use on drugs, you know. I don't need to say, because you know more than I do, because I don't have time to listen to this type of bullshit. What you are bringing to your environment, what kind of music you are playing in your back garden. Do you understand how serious it is? If you want to change your way of thinking and your way of life, you want to change your life, you have to do it. You have to look at everything and be proactive in your life in every single way. The quality of your life depends on you only. What you are doing, what you are listening, what you are reading. The quality of your life is moved by what you are thinking, what you are listening, what material you are putting in your files, in your archive here. Life is not about what you have financially, materially. Life is about what you are and what are you feeding your brain. That's what life is about. Because if you feed your brain with prosperity, you're going to have prosperity. If you feed your brain with love, you're going to have love back. If you feed your brain with good health, you're going to have a good health back. I'm going to talk lately about vampires. Okay, I'm going to talk lately about vampires. And you're going to understand what I said about these people that comes and glue on your energy to feed from you, okay? It's going to be more clear later in another video, okay? And life is not about just thoughts, it's about feelings. What are you feeling? And when you bring your thoughts to the feeling side, then it makes some difference inside you. Do you understand what I'm saying? Thoughts follow by feelings. It's what makes your life changing. If you think about positivity and feel it in your body, it gets glued to you. I'm going to talk about it lately. and about positive thinking. What is really positive thinking? Okay? How to be proactive in positive thinking. The world inside you is what creates the world outside you. I'm going to leave you with this thought. The world inside you is the one that controls the world outside you. What you are inside yourself, what you are here, is what the world is outside. I hope I have helped you today. Yes, I know it's going to be a lot of questions inside you. And you are free to ask me these questions, okay? But that's what I'm here for. To feed your brain with something good, to question your life and to question your way of thinking and your way of perceiving, so you can improve and I can improve myself also. So be free to contact me if you need it and if you want it, okay? Leave your feedback. And if you like it. God bless you and see you next time. Okay? Bye-bye.